Let's hear a big MIT yell for the yellow team.
Hello, everyone, and welcome. My name is John. This is Ishwar, and our third presenter is Celine. We are so happy and proud to present Manta, a rope-launching rescue system for crew overboard situations. Falling off of a boat is a terrifying experience. The person in the water is dealing with the effects of panic and possibly freezing cold temperatures. The crew is attempting difficult rescue maneuvers while constantly maintaining line of sight with their crewmates so they don't become lost at sea. From 2012 to 2017, there were almost 2,000 reported incidents of crew overboard in the United States, and over half of them resulted in death. These deaths were not simply caused by adverse conditions or rough seas. 9 out of 10 occurred in calm waters. After speaking with experienced sailors, boat captains, and the U.S. Coast Guard, it was clear that there was a need for a faster and more reliable method of rescue. Manta meets that need. Manta is a rope launcher that fires a loop attached to two flotation devices. This instantly creates a perimeter around the person in the water and ensures that they will not float away from you. Now, retrieving them and returning them safely to the side of your boat is simply a matter of reeling in some rope. Now let's see Manta in action out on the water.
To test it out, we took a trip to the Boston Sailing Center, located in Boston Harbor, and practiced a man overboard drill. The first step when someone goes overboard is to stop and point at the victim and alert the rest of the crew. Then Manta is removed from its waterproof case, the adjustable stock is set, the device is placed against your shoulder, cocked back and primed for use, the safety is depressed, which is next to the trigger, and the user fires when ready. Upon impact with the water, the projectiles inflate and become life preservers. At this point, it's simply a matter of reeling in the rope until the victim, which in this case is a dummy, is safely next to the boat. We tested Manta with 12 users who had never seen our device before, and all 12 successfully encircled the victim on their first try.
Manta has a 100-foot reach and a 20-degree angle of separation, which dramatically improves on current methods. Presently, if you wanted to encircle someone with a loop of rope, you would have to do so by driving your boat around them. This maneuver can take time and lead to multiple missed attempts. Manta creates the same perimeter in a matter of seconds. Once you've launched Manta, you can breathe easy, knowing that your crewmate is saved. Now let's get into some of the technical details.
From talking with users, we knew that safety, reliability, and speed were all key product attributes. Manta is powered by 22 caliber gunpowder cartridges. The cartridges are safe, compact, and efficient. The cartridges are located on the front of the launcher. With the front closed, the projectiles can slide right over. The launcher is also made of an ergonomic grip and comfortable collapsible shoulder stock. The entire Manta system is stored inside of the waterproof case at the stern of the boat. As you can imagine, boats are constantly moving, and we need to design Manta so that it can be safely used at sea. We built a dual safety trigger system, which allows the user to still use it with one hand, but fire safely. The charging handle gets cocked, but only when the thumb safety and trigger are engaged will the two firing pins move forward and strike the charges. This then pushes expanding gas forward to send our projectiles out. We ran over 200 trials with Manta to show that we can safely and repeatedly launch our projectiles. Now, why don't we take a look at this live in action? We'd have loved to have all of you on a yacht on the Charles with us, but it was a little over our budget. So instead, today, we're going to be launching into this net located over here as it comes up. This demonstration will be a little loud, but you've all been provided with ear protection in your safety supplies box, or you can cover your ears.
Man overboard!
In a crew overboard situation, Sailor Lauren will first turn her boat around and approach the victim. She'll slow down and go to the stern of her boat and grab Manta. She removes it from the case. as well as an accompanying rope bag, and sets it on the ground. She gets set. If you haven't already done so, please cover your ears or use ear protection. Lauren? 3, 2, 1. The Manta projectiles have been designed to be aerodynamic and strong on launch to survive the launch forces. However, on impact with water, they inflate into life preservers within 10 seconds, providing up to 200 pounds of buoyancy for a person. Let's take a look at the projectiles in action. And while it inflates, let's take a look at how the projectiles are made of. There we go. Our projectiles are made of an impact-resistant plastic and aluminum core, which cushions the impact to our payload. Above this is an auto-inflation mechanism similar to those found in high-end life jackets. This includes a CO2 canister and uses a salt capsule as a trigger to trigger our inflation on impact with water. Can we give a huge round of applause for our sailor, Lauren?
When we thought about bringing our product to market, we decided to initially target key user groups in the local area, like the U.S. Coast Guard, local sailing organizations, and U.S. Sailing Safety at Sea Division. For the first 6 months, we intend to launch a pilot program where we will ensure that these groups have the appropriate safety training and support that they'll need as Manta continues to develop. Then for the next year, we'll launch a paid pilot program in which these groups will pay us a small fee. By 2021, we hope to sell directly to consumers through online sales and also in stores like West Marine. There are 400,000 registered boats between 20 and 100 feet in the US, and that market is growing at 6% year over year for the next 5 years. Once we've saturated the local Northeast market, we intend to expand to the Mid-Atlantic and West Coast. We estimate the cost per unit of Manta at $260, including overhead, labor, and materials, while we ultimately will sell Manta for an entire system of $700, including a waterproof case, the launcher, two projectiles, and rope. Additional projectiles will be sold separately because each is intended for single use. The closest comparable product to Manta right now costs almost 3 times as much and only launches a single rope. So Manta does more for less at $700. Additionally, the users that we're targeting already spend thousands of dollars on U.S. Coast Guard recommended and required safety equipment. With Manta, our hope is that fewer crew overboard incidents end in tragedy. We're launching into a safer world at sea. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Shreya, and I'm one of the 2009 mentors and tonight's moderator for the Q&A. I'd like to welcome everyone here and watching on the webcast. There are 2 ways you can ask a question. You can raise your hand if you're here in Kresge, and Rich or Ellen will come find you and throw a mic at you. You can catch it. If you're watching online, you can ask a question on Twitter using the hashtag 009Danger. You can also follow live tweets of the show at 009Minions. So with that, let's take a question for Yellow Team.
Hello. Is there a lanyard or anything to connect the operator and the firing mechanism to the boat? A lot of stuff's going on there. You're dropping sails, you're trying to head up into the wind and so forth or whatever. Do you have a lanyard to connect you to the boat?
Yeah, so The launcher itself is not connected to the boat. However, the rope is connected to the box, which is mounted onto the back of the launcher, or back of the boat, sorry.
Thank you. Over here?
Okay, are other prototypes of the Manta going to be quieter?
Hey, that's an amazing question. So we do recognize that the sound is definitely a factor. However, in our research, based on our user kind of surveys, we found out that in an emergency situation, the noise level is not the utmost importance to our users. But however, we do plan to address this in future models. We have explored plenty of methods to reduce noise, one of which is a sheath that covers the circular area that you see and extend outward. That way, it deflects the compressive noise waves away from the user. Thank you.
Thank you. Question here?
Yes. So when you fire the device, you end up having like two floats and then a rope between them. Is there any concern that, say, like the center rope might hit the person?
So in terms of making sure that the center rope doesn't hit the person, the rope is pretty small, so we're not so concerned about the impact force of the rope hurting the person if it hits them. In addition, the long range of Manta means that we expect the rope to encircle the person pretty well. In terms of the projectiles hitting the person, the rope actually should be slowing all the projectiles in the whole system down as it moves forward, since there's so much drag, since there's so much rope. So we don't expect it to be too dangerous as it, you know, goes out far enough to reach the distance of a person.
Thank you. We have a question over here.
I'm just kind of curious. If one of the cartridges misfires, is this thing going to whip around?
Again, great question. So we have done testing to simulate a launch failure on one of our projectiles, and we have found that it does not swing around and hit the user.
Good news. I have a related question from Twitter. If Manta misses, how long does it take to reload?
I got it.
So if Manta misses, we don't intend for the user to fire another round. Mostly because that would mean that there's two sets of rope and two projectiles in the water, which could be a really big hazard on board a boat. What we would intend is for users to do the current maneuver, which would be to circle around with the boat, with the rope and projectile trailing, until they're safely encircled.
Thank you. One more question over here.
Yep. How is Manta's envelope affected by headwinds and crosswinds, that 100 feet you advertise?
So based on our testing, our fuel testing, definitely the wind does have an effect. However, we out in the range, we found that, one, it's not that significant of a wind. And especially in crosswinds, you do see a deviation, but it's not that great. But we also do advise our users to position their vessel upwind so that you're not affected by lateral wind shift.
Thank you. That's all we have time for. So let's thank Yellow Team. Come this way.